Welcome to This Is Important, a production of iHeartRadio, the show where we only talk about what's the most important, bottom line, critical thing happening on this planet. Today on This Is Important?
Now that I've eaten your butt, I would love to have a kiss.
Hello, last time I checked, Jesus makes water into wine. Hello.
Yeah, dude, I fucking jack-blasted Craig.
Have you ever eaten butt to Trop House music, though?
Buckle up.
Oh,
okay.
Back to This Is Important. This week we're celebrating Trop House.
Man,
yeah,
Trop
wow.
House.
Tropical house music.
I'm very excited. I'm very happy. I just taught something. I just taught my friends something about music, which I don't know if I've ever done. Usually they're the ones that tell me about new music. I'm usually pretty bad. I only know bands that were popular between 1994 and 2004.
Yeah, true.
Mm-hmm. That was your decade.
Adam, you just put me on.
Yeah, I just told them about Trop House.
Trop House. This is tropical house mashup music.
And that's what we were just playing, and the vibe is fucking hella good, dude. Mm-hmm. Okay?
So last year, we went to a PGA tournament on Kauai Island here in South Carolina.
Gorgeous.
And me and McBride and a bunch of people, and we somehow got hooked up with... somehow we got hooked up with Kygo's manager Miles. Big shout out to manager Miles. Good dude. And he put me on to, he was like, Kygo. I didn't know much about Kygo. I've since, now I know more. And he was telling me that it's called Trop House music. And evidently Kygo was one of the first people, if not the first people, to kind of do this.
Mm-hmm. He's a founder of Trop House.
Trop House music.
Wow. So is that's kind of the vibe? It's kind of like W Hotel lobby, just like fucking kicking it.
Yeah, it's like chill. It's, you're on vacation, you know? It just is kind of like,
yeah, it's vacation. Yeah, it's slam.
Yeah, it's like music for a hotel lobby, right? Like if you're in an elevator, maybe.
Well, is that bad?
No, that's just a vibe that exists.
Oh, hello. I feel like the most relaxed I ever am is in a W Hotel lobby.
Really? I hate the W Hotel lobby.
What? Yeah.
I think they're fine if they want to give me some.
What?
Some,
but you can't deny that.
Fine,
you can't deny that. That W would be playing stuff like that. You know, that is what you're going to be hearing.
Oh, yeah. They've come around. I won't deny that.
I know. I can't deny it. You're right.
I won't deny that.
I won't. I can't.
I'm astonished you guys don't fuck with the W Hotel lobby vibe.
Well, I'm not on the I
Thank
love
you,
this vibe. I
Thank
love,
you,
I've
Kyle.
Been listening to like chill music 2022, chill summer. These are the playlists.
You know what? I don't like it. It's a little too loud. When you walk into a hotel where the music's just a little too loud already.
I'm not talking volume. We're not talking volume.
This is going to be a problem.
Here's my problem with W Hotels is they're fun if it's like a bachelor party weekend or something.
Yeah. Okay.
And it's like
my life is a bachelor party.
101 bachelor parties.
You're there just to party. It's just you and your dudes, and it's just you're throwing down. But my first stand-up tour, it's exhausting. You're on the road for like a month straight. You're doing shows every night. You need to get a good night's rest at the end of the night because you're going to be on a plane the next morning. Mm-hmm. It's very hectic.
Pizza, pizza.
Isaac put me up in W Hotels. So every night I'm at a W Hotel. You can never – you turn on a light switch, and it'll just be like – a neon light that says like party o'clock or whatever the fuck it says above your bed, and
you're
just like,
guy,
I can't even see to like get water in the middle of the night because you'll flip on light and it'll just be some like ambient glow behind a mirror, and you're like, well, that doesn't help me wash my face in the morning.
No, I hear you. I mean, we stayed at the W.
And that's Adam's major priority is what helps him wash his face.
All the body lotion has glitter. Dude. All the body lotion has glitter in it.
Yeah, the body lotion just is covered in glitter.
Oh, shit.
What
oh,
the fuck, bro? I'm sorry.
That's where we stayed when we did house party, right?
Honey, did you go to the strip club? No, I swear to God, babe. I just put on some body lotion.
And then she starts going through your receipts and finds like, oh, you were at the W. Okay, I'm sorry. I'm sorry.
My bad.
Okay, I didn't realize you were at the W.
You should have said you were at the W.
That's a vibe.
That's a Trop House vibe.
Dude, Trop House. I'm all about it.
But they do a thing, the Palm Tree Festival, I think it's called.
WTF is that?
Where they have like a big festival, Kygo performs, and then they have like Jimmy Buffett perform and stuff.
I'm kind of liking this.
Well, of course. Jimmy Buffett is like one of the best vibes of all time. If you're talking Trop.
He's the original Trop.
He's the original Trop
vibes.
Uh-huh. Yeah. That's the guy.
Does he come out? Do they like do a little set together? That could get pretty crazy.
I don't know. I've not been to this festival. I've just seen it.
I am intrigued.
Since now I follow the manager Miles and Kygo now.
What's it called? Palm Tree Festival?
I believe so, yeah.
I'm intrigued, man.
We gotta go.
All right. Yeah, I could see Buffett up there. Buffett up there just soaking in the fucking sun. Talking about cheeseburgers in paradise. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Pencil thin mustache.
Two cheeseburgers in paradise.
Not the song.
That's the song. That's it.
Guess where it takes place.
My guess is Miami.
Florida Keys.
It takes place in the most Trop House place you'll ever...
Ozarks.
No, is it Lake of the Ozarks?
It's Florida Keys.
Nope.
Ah, shucks.
Is it Miami?
No, it's got to be somewhere where people... Yeah, like...
Hawaii? Is it in America? Is it in North America?
Is it the Bahamas?
I don't think so.
Okay, it's not. So it's Bahamas?
He doesn't think so.
Ibiza?
Closer.
It's gotta be Ibiza.
But that was a great answer, Durst. If this was Family Feud, that's up there.
Is it Ibiza? I thought it was Ibiza.
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 Either way, Ibiza. It's not there. You want the answer?
Okay, but it's close. You said something close?
Yeah, just tell us.
Give us another hint. Give us another hint. No, don't.
Wait, geographically close or like
don't you say close?
Okay, Marshalltown, Iowa.
Marshalltown, Iowa.
Wow.
Shout out Marshalltown.
It's in none other than Croatia, baby.
Oh, wait. What just happened?
Okay.
This might be the next one because they had one, I swear, in Miami. I think they're just doing a different festival every 3 months or whatever.
Yeah, smart.
Dude, what is up with Croatia? Can we talk about it, please?
I have no idea.
What is up with it?
Yeah, I got a homie there right now.
What is up with it? It looks so sick.
It's supposed to be beautiful.
What do you mean, what's up with it? Yeah, it's supposed to be a beautiful, awesome place.
Yes, it looks gorgeous. I'm just Googling it, and I'm, like, getting a boner over here.
You've never...
I don't know anything about it.
I've never Googled Croatia before.
Dude, that's why the movie The Crow is so dope, because it was based, like...
I almost did a pretty bad movie on the sole purpose that I was going to shoot it in Croatia. I, like, really...
This place looks insane. Where is this now?
I was really like, no, I think maybe we should do this.
Right.
Dude, I have never looked this place up. It's bordered by Slovenia and Hungary and Bosnia.
Who's hungry?
Wow.
I wonder if we could get a deal with the W Hotel, like, chain to do the podcast live at their exotic locations, like Croatia.
Do you think they have a Croatia? W Croatia?
Well, the W Hotels as a brand, I hope they do.
Yeah.
They got reach.
I hope they do. And you know what? I take it back. If I'm there just to party, if it's to go with you guys and we're just going to go and we're going to party, we're going to do the podcast and just have a great time, I'm all for the W Hotel. I don't need to see how to get dressed in the morning.
Yeah, right.
You know, I don't need light switches to actually turn on the actual light and not like some inspirational quote on the wall.
This is an unearthed love for the W that I'm sniffing out right now that you just kind of buried and
he
was
knows
like,
it
fuck
well.
The dub. And then you were like, hold up, wait, I actually dig it.
Well, no, by the time I got week three in and I'm in a new city in a new hotel every night and you go to turn on a light so you can see what you're doing.
Well, that'll ring. That'll test you anyways. Yeah. 3 weeks on the road will test you even if you're staying at the nicest of nice. You know? Nicest you're always moving. Nice. You got no roots. Your butt's always on the go.
I mean, you also don't even want to stay at the nicest of nice on that kind of grind because you can't really enjoy it. So, like, the W is a perfect thing where you got all the amenities.
Thank you.
It works for the W Hotel. What the hell?
It's got the vibe in the lobby. Yeah. The vibe in the lobby is right.
You got music just loud enough to wake you up, but not so loud to not let you snooze.
Same volume at 5 a.m. and 5 p.m.
I drank last night. Have you guys ever seen this or had this? Pappy Van Winkle?
Excuse me?
I feel like I have, whiskey? But...
Burbank? Bourbon?
Burbank. It's from whiskey. Right here in Burbank, California.
Brewed right in. I don't think they brew whiskey, but yes.
Burbank bourbon.
Distilled.
Cast.
Distilled in beautiful Burbank.
Yeah, Pappy Van Winkle. I went and played cards at a friend's house, and he busted out this bottle. It was like a $5,000 or $10,000 bottle of bourbon. Yeah.
What kind of cards you playing, Adam?
What kind of friends you got?
I don't know. And the card game was like, I was one of the big winners. I won $200. So I don't know why he busted out this crazy expensive bottle of
what were you playing?
Whiskey. He said it was a gift. So he's like, yeah, sure, let's drink it.
What card games were you playing?
Texas Hold'ems.
Oh, okay. Yeah, is that where you got the river? Yeah. The river card? And the flop? You wait for the flop?
Yeah, very good.
The flop. The flop and the boohoo.
We should play cards together sometimes. The flop and the boohoo. Yeah.
The zip, the flop, the boohoo, baby.
Okay.
Yeah, I feel like we got to play cards sometime, Kyle.
Yeah, I would love to.
Now that I know that you don't really know the rules, we got to play.
Blackjack, When I go to Vegas, I play blackjack. That's my shit.
Or is this his bluff?
Yeah, it could be. His long con.
Mm-hmm. I'm not very good at poker.
See what he's doing?
Yeah, I'm better at blackjack. I am. I like playing blackjack more than poker, but I will play poker with you for sure. Mm-hmm. That just gets old after a while.
Well, blackjack is a hard game to play just with your friends because, you know, no one's going to be the casino.
So, I know. But, it's you got to have a house.
Poker face.
I'd like to play cards with you guys. We're not a real card crew, though. I feel like I probably play it the most, and I play one time a year. So
I don't know. I get on. I told you guys I used to do it via the iPad. So I'm kind of a gambler in that way. So.
Mm. Oh right, you were playing online poker.
Is that real, Bam?
It's real, yeah, and I love to play cards, and I'd love to play with you, Adam.
I would love that. Let's get it together, man.
I would love to.
Who knew this? I didn't know this.
Playing cards is so fun.
I think I somewhere
$10,000 whiskey is that in the
What's it's called? Pappy Van Winkle.
Yeah, I'm surprised you guys haven't heard of this. I got deep into.
Why is it so expensive? Is it a
whiskey? It's very good. And it's distilled like 20 years.
How much better is it than like fucking Four Roses?
Wild Turkey. It's
better than Wild Turkey.
Wild Turkey is a barn burner.
It is very good. It's very, very smooth.
Talk to me about Wild Turkey.
But like it's $10,000. You're drinking it. Why are you spending $10,000 on it? How old is it?
And also, why is it called Pappy Van Winkle?
Well, he didn't. He was given it as a gift. So he didn't buy that.
Why does it cost $10,000, I guess?
Because they only release something like 7,000 cases a year. And they only give it to liquor stores. Like they'll give you a bottle per liquor store if you move all of the all of their other whiskeys. So it's a big distillery and this is their nicest stuff.
Okay.
And I think it's like I'm blanking on the name of the
and then the liquor store is like, we don't care because no one's going to come in here and buy that bottle of $10,000 whiskey.
No, they will. They can't keep it like it's on.
Yeah, there's like whiskey collectors.
They have like deals with the high end collectors that are like, if, as soon as you get one, I'll pay $5,000 or $10,000 or whatever it was.
Yeah, wow. That seems about par for the course. What people are paying for booze?
I looked it up this morning, being like, how much was that? Because he was saying, I think it's $5, and then another or $5,000. Another guy was like,
$5.
I think it's $10,000. And I looked it up, and it seems like you can find it for $5,000. But then everyone on the pages were like, well, good luck actually getting it. They list it for this, but then actually finding it is much harder.
And it's aftermarket. kind of thing. So if you see it, you should just buy that shit and flip it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
And then are you a bootlegger, technically? Or do you have to be making it to be a bootlegger?
Yeah, I think you have to make it to consider yourself a bootlegger.
Mm-hmm. Well, do you know what the bootlegger was? The race cars that ran that shit ran booze in the trunk. That's how they started NASCAR.
Yeah, that was the Kennedys, the Kennedy family.
And that's why it's called the boot?
Yeah, the boot.
That's what they did?
The boot is the trunk?
Yeah, the boot's the trunk. And then they would have the legs.
And the legs are the wheels?
Legs are probably the trips. Like the leg of the trip.
John's father...
Adam, what are you talking about?
Was it his father or his grandfather? I think it was his father was a huge bootlegger.
Right.
And that's how they made their fortune.
The pizza.
And then when it became legal, he immediately was just already doing it. So he was the main distributor.
What a fucking strange time.
I mean, that's like weed dealers too. It's like, hey, I already know this much about weed and have this much experience. Let's make it legal.
I wonder how the hell did we get there? Yeah.
And now it's legal and I'm fully plugged in.
What, how do we get to the prohibition?
How the hell did we get to the point where we were like, yo, alcohol is like, what party did some motherfucker just go way off the rails and they're like, we're done. Booze is over.
Wasn't it like religion?
Yeah, the religious right.
Oh, God.
Took hold and made it illegal during the 20s.
Hello. Last time I checked, Jesus mixed water into wine. Hello.
Wait,
God made
quick.
Beer. It's proof that he wants us to be happy. Ben Franklin.
I got a better Ben question. Franklin. When did they make it legal again?
Yeah, like, when did they blow the door?
Why were they like, we got to just fucking
fuck
party.
This, brother.
And it landed, imagine turning.
All right, I'm going to get on the.
What, 18, I think, back then?
Google.
The day that it turned illegal. And you're like, well, fuck. And then you have to go a decade without drinking.
Yeah.
That would suck.
Okay, it was 13 years, bros. 13 years, man.
13 years, yeah.
What the hell?
What's wild is it's prohibition.
The best times.
Weird, wild stuff.
That's a whole generation of alcoholics that we've lost.
Oh, right. That sucks, man.
Okay, so here's what the interesting part. I did not think it was this. It was 1920 to 1933, so right during the Roaring Twenties, during prohibition.
Mm-hmm. Oh, my. Yeah.
Yes.
Wait, but
people
here's
the fucking party.
What do you mean? Yes, it was during Prohibition. That's what Prohibition was.
I didn't know that the Roaring Twenties was the same as Prohibition. I didn't know
well,
that.
I don't think either.
I think that's a little wild because that probably why all the parties fucking kicked ass because it was illegal and there was no bars.
Yeah, it was hella secret.
Because they were all underground. So you had to like be in the know. So it was like. So, like, in New York City where there was, like, an underground party scene that was, like, a
Harlem,
big thing.
Baby.
It makes me go, like, dang, that I bet that was really fun to go get drunk and being drunk was illegal.
Right. Like, yeah, it's like you're just a teenager forever.
Yeah. I bet that was, like, really fun. Because remember how fun it was to get drunk before you could actually get drunk?
Yeah. Now it's just kind of sad.
Now it's real. There's a whole thing about it.
Now you walk into a bar and it's just you and Orlando Bloom winking at each other.
Right. You're looking in the mirror, you're holding the baby. It's getting weird. Yeah.
Do you want to know why they did this?
In
1920. So it says National Prohibition of Alcohol from 20 this to 33 important. Was called Diarrhea. The Noble Experiment.
The Noble?
Yeah. The fucking Noble Experiment. That's so wild.
It's like Adam taking 2 weeks off. America was like, yo, we just got to slow down.
Let's take a decade off of not drinking. Who's with me?
Who's with me?
Nobody. Nobody.
I need a break. Asshole president was in charge when...
Who was our president?
This fucking...
Let's see. 1920s.
This is important, baby.
Grover Cleveland. Who was our guy?
1920 prez.
And was the Kennedy presidency a fucking... slapback? Was that fucking like, to do the not go away, now we knew why?
Now I'm going to get my boy in here.
Well, it was his son, and then when was Kennedy? It was the 60s, right?
Yeah, that's a little
this
later.
Is important.
That's much later than the 20s and 30s.
Oh, so, yeah, he had 30 years.
Mm-hmm. I know, but hey, you know, the arc of history bends slowly.
Yeah, you're right. So history is
the arc of history is like your own dick bending back into your butt.
It's looking like looking like Wood,
almost exactly like that.
Woodrow Wilson kicked it off. Fucking yeah.
Oh, Woodrow, that fucking prick.
Okay, Woody. Woody.
I bet Woodrow.
Woodrow.
Do you think? I mean, Woodrow seems like a guy who had like a really
Woodrow.
He's got Drow in the name.
I know. He's a weed toker. He smokes, bro.
He had a really shitty wife, I think. I think he has like a wife that was super religious.
What was her name?
Is that what you're saying? You're
Woodrow, baby. Let's blow that Woodrow.
I'm not seeing. I don't know enough about that.
Beer's illegal, man. You have to come over to my house and smoke.
Oh, I thought I had read about that at one point. That like she was super religious and was like, no, this has to happen. And he's like, okay.
Well, isn't that like what happens? Like,
I'm a man.
Like the war on drugs and shit. Wasn't that like religious?
Woodrow.
Yeah, that, in like the '80s.
No, that was Reagan's wife or whatever. Just say no.
Yeah, Nancy Reagan.
Reagan. Dude, look at us go.
Yeah, that was like some religious backing.
Did we already go into this? How like the internet blew up Nancy Reagan a few months ago and was like,
we're having sloppy toppy.
Apparently, she was like, oh, she had that Gag 2000.
Gag 3000.
Wait.
What is this?
You didn't hear about this?
No, Durs, explain.
Wait, like, what? Nancy Reagan?
Yeah, 6 months ago, the internet blew up and was like, the reason that Ronald Reagan like went on his first date with her was because she was known in Hollywood to have that turbo head. And
what?
Then he married her.
Thank you, God. Yeah.
And it was like she had legendary dome, apparently, which is great. Cool.
Yeah, which is fucking sick as fuck. That's a sick stamp.
I mean, fuck, that is so tight. Good job.
But it really does rewrite history, doesn't it?
What was what was Nancy Reagan in Hollywood? What was that? Was she
an actress as well, or just because Ronald was that big swinging dick?
She was just a groupie.
Yeah, I don't know.
Because Ronald was an actor.
It was on the internet, so
it has to be real. Yeah.
Just say no.
It was on the internet, so it has to be real.
And then they were just doing videos of her like zooming in on her eyes looking at Mr. T, and it was like all she wanted was that dick. And I'm like, is this now just getting like
strange?
Or like,
yeah,
well, I don't know why we were slamming her
getting strange.
I can't remember what it was, but it was like people were trying to celebrate her, and then somebody was like, nah, she just had like dope head. Here we go.
And did you say sloppy toppings?
Sloppy toppy.
Oh, I thought you said sloppy toppings.
Nancy Reagan is trending for allegedly being renowned in Hollywood for performing oral sex. Here's why it seems more complex.
That is so cool.
So what was her deal? Why was she in Hollywood? What's going on?
That changes the course of history.
Nancy Reagan? I'm about to find out why she was in.
That changes the course of history for me.
It does. It absolutely does, and I'm digging deeper.
Yeah, it makes me think she's kind of cool. Like,
kind of cool.
Well, she also kind of wasn't cool.
Kind of.
You know, the war on drugs, I think, kind of sucks.
Bro,
but
this was
sloppy toppy does sound cool.
Yeah, but this doesn't. You don't think this undoes that entirely?
I feel like it rights a lot of wrongs.
It does not
it definitely
rights a lot of wrongs for me.
Yeah.
Oh,
she
here we go.
War on drugs.
Here we go.
She was like, I was fucking high doing all this.
Bro, she was a Hollywood actress in the 40s and 50s. Mm-hmm. Starring in such films as The Next Voice You Hear, Night Into Morning, and Donovan's Brain.
Behind the Green Door.
All right, and in 52...
Wait, what was the last one? Donovan's Brain?
Yeah.
Brain?
Wait. She was letting us know.
Did you say Behind the Green Door? Was she really in the Behind the Green Door? Wasn't that a porno?
Oh, Behind the Green Door was like the first porno in like theaters or something? No, I dropped that one.
Oh, okay. No. I thought.
Why do you guys know this?
Yeah, how did you know?
You don't know about that?
Behind the Green Door is, that's like...
It's legendary in cinema.
But well, is it the first porno?
I mean, I knew it once you said it, but it was weird that you had Behind the Green Door in the chamber ready to go. Yeah.
Right there on the tip of the tongue.
Hey, just tip to cap this, just to cap this Nancy Reagan thing. This was in 1952.
Okay,
no cap. All right, down boy.
That's cap.
This was in 1952 that she that she married Reagan. So that's just, you know, the 50s were actually kind of tight.
Yeah.
And by the way, this is like eating booty. Nobody, people weren't doing it like that back then.
True.
Oh, slurping?
It was. This was like, yeah, this is like new frontier shit.
Well, they weren't talking about it.
No, I mean, I don't know what it like.
When was the first blowjob?
Yeah, I feel like that's been.
That shit's in Egyptian art.
But it ebbs and flows. No, hold up.
Yeah, I feel like that's been happening.
History of oral sex.
But it ebbs. Well, of course, and eating booties was happening before too, but now it's like the thing.
Now it's back. Yeah. Now it's really
well,
back.
Then Kevin Gates came out and had an interview about eating butt like groceries and firestorm.
There's nothing wrong with that.
That's what I'm saying. It's like that was not like on the checklist of when you're in middle school being like, all right, I need a hand job. I need to like suck some boobs, get a blowjob and fuck. Nobody was like, dude, you know you could slip in booty eating right between blowjob and fucking.
Well, I feel like booty
of course
eating
you can.
Is that's an advanced level. You don't go right to that. That's not like the first. That wouldn't be on your middle school checklist.
Kyle's feeling attacked.
I think that it is now. I think
Kyle's feeling attacked.
Eating
He's
booties
feeling
before having sex.
But what I'm saying Kyle's is, Adam, yeah, you're right. But we are in it.
Kyle's super backed in the corner right now.
We are in advanced.
Wait. We're speaking for all booty eaters.
No, there's nothing wrong with it.
No, I'm just saying we are. Yeah, that's advanced, but we are advancing as a people. So, you know, it should come right in between oral sex and fucking.
No.
Are we?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Listen, I think that booty eating is probably before sex for like high schoolers and middle schoolers.
What? What is that?
I love it.
Give me some context. What do you mean?
What?
I think booty eating is probably before sex. Because I guarantee you it is. Because look, you're already down there. If you're going down on some chick, you're already down there. You're probably like, I'm going to do the thing they're rapping about.
Right.
Because she's not letting me fuck.
Right. So I'm going to try this. You're right. You're absolutely right.
Well, I see. I don't think that it is.
I'm pissed now.
I feel like it's still an advanced move.
Because you're old. You're old. You don't know any better. It's new to you. You think it's advanced because you're like, you don't get it.
You're old, bro. You're old school. This is the roaring 20s, 2020 to 2023. Yeah, we're out here bootying, bro. This is the roaring 20s.
Thank you, God.
I know like what like Catholic girls are like willing to go anal before vaginal to like keep it.
Yeah, because God is watching.
Sure. Yeah.
But that's like a rumor. Like
And that's more advanced, or is it?
Disappointed!
I don't know how real it is, but yes.
That's about as real as Nancy Reagan being the queen of the Thunderdome.
That is real. That is 100% real.
Yeah.
You could just
How
tell.
How are you in denial, Adam? How do you...
You could see it in her crazy eyes.
How do you not see this as something that is probable that it's happening?
I do think it's probable. And I do think it...
anything is probable.
It's happening. I don't think it's as widespread...
Points. Yes, points.
By the way, go ahead. I'm not going to get into it.
Widespread as we're making it out to be. I still feel eating booty is an advanced.
Frowned upon.
That's because you're old. I don't think it's advanced for these kids.
Motherfucker, you're old.
I know.
I know about Trop House, dog.
Yes, points.
I don't think it's advanced for these young
Have you
bucks.
Ever eaten butt to Trop House music, though?
Wait, so are you... is your argument that eating booty is like third base?
Yeah,
it's shortstop.
Third base has been replaced with booty eating?
No, it's shortstop. So. It's in between second and third is the shortstop. Yeah. You just hit it.
Oh, my God.
You just hit it. You check it out.
So what is third base again? It's been
Damn. Miguel Tejada?
It's been a while since I've broken it down to bases. Yeah,
it's Tejada.
Well, yeah, no, that is true. What first base is just kissing, or is first base titties?
I thought first base was copping, like was touching. I think you have to go
heavy petting.
Like, you lose.
Heavy petting, kissing, heavy petting combo. First base.
Second base is handy.
Kissing.
The rules of the sport.
Kissing is last for Kyle.
Kissing is home base.
Finally, his home run.
He's like, it's the most special. I won't do it.
I bait your butt.
Well, that's when you know you're in love.
I'd love to have a kiss.
Exactly. That's the deal sealer.
Now that I've eaten your butt, I would love to have a kiss.
No, first base is kissing.
I would love to have a kiss.
First base is kissing.
Second base is cop and a feel.
Second base is cop and feel, so I guess we could throw in
booty eating and shortstop.
Or and my favorite word, finger bang.
So
who came up with that?
What? Blasting.
Who came up with finger blasting? What? Come on.
Smoking.
Yeah, that's the worst.
Well, the bang was already pretty intense. When they went to blast.
I know.
That's
and our girls running around being like, dude, I fucking jack blasted that guy.
No.
Like, why are we doing this? Why are we saying we finger banged and finger blasted? And women or girls are like,
jack blasted.
Yeah, dude. I fucking jack blasted Craig.
You just been jack blasted. Damn, I don't think I've ever been jack blasted in my life.
No. I just hand banged him.
Yeah, hand blasted? That's like.
There's not a blasting happening.
Third base is.
Jack blast
is oral. It's got to be cunnilingus and
dynamite.
That's where you slip.
Okay, so see, we're saying all right. So we're saying third base is
it's oral,
and eating booty is between second and third base. That seems
no. Between home and
okay,
yeah.
No, the bases are moving, and you're moving the goalposts.
Yeah.
This bro's out here moving goalposts.
Yeah, well, it's two different sports. Well,
eating booty is when
eating booty is arguably a different sport.
You know when they throw the ball and you're caught between like a tag out or whatever. What do they call that? Where they're trying to run by?
Yeah, your
pickle.
Hot box.
That's called pickle. That's the pickle, original pickle ball.
Okay,
pickle.
They're trying to run you down, so you're caught just going back and forth eating booty, just trying to get home.
Dip and seat.
There's more. We need more bases in baseball in order to actually do this.
Dipping tea with Adam D.
That is true.
Hey, that is actually a pretty cool idea for the sport of baseball. What if they added two bases?
Ooh,
two what?
Two bases.
Bases.
Two bases. Kind of like rock and jock basketball, how they had like two more hoops. What if we do rock and jock softball with two more bases?
How is the Oakland Athletics doing?
Poorly.
Aren't they doing really bad? Like, I think someone...
Wait, why
was
are
it you
doing this?
That was telling me that they have like 3,000 fans in their stadium?
What are you doing?
What are you doing, man?
We got to get more fans in that stadium, man. What the heck's going on?
Okay, yeah. All right, cool. Good.
If we want to deep dive it, it's like kind of like the team is kind of notorious for like selling off all their players of value, and they kind of were like building up this.
It's the worst part of being a fan.
They were building up this team.
Mm-hmm.
Do they have like a shitty owner? Is that what's happening?
No, it's just their strategy.
They just don't spend money.
It's management.
Yes.
Money. So
I can't get into it. It's management.
It is. It's the Billy Bean. Billy Bean set the precedent, and then they've just kind of been rolling with it. You know, cheap and always moving.
Well, maybe you guys need to pitch him fifth base.
But yeah, if we pitch him a couple extra bases, if you come to Oakland and you have to run a couple extra bases, that could get the butts in the seat.
Only in Oakland. I love that.
Yeah, that's where you get the extra baseball.
Wait, did we talk about that Savannah Bananas or whatever? We talked about that, right?
No, but I...
Oh, yeah, the...
I watched Real Sports about it.
Yeah, it's like this team out in Savannah, Georgia. They're called like the Bananas, I think. And they play baseball with like totally different rules. Like they have like flaming bats and you can like, it's like bizarre. It looks fun as fuck.
You got to like get your clothes off by the time you get to home base.
What?
Yeah.
And that's why, cool. Like the minor leagues are really fun. There's the minor league baseball team, the River Dogs here in Charleston, the games are just so fun. It's like they're not doing all the crazy stuff that they're doing in Savannah, but it's like there's just like mascots walking around all the time and like stuff for kids. And there's just like batting cages that you can go to during the game and like pitching machines. And
is this
it's just really
AAA?
Cool. I'm like, oh, this is... Yeah,
that's a triple A.
Might even be like double A or single A, but
I mean, the Cubs were so bad for so long that was also the vibe of Wrigley. It's just a giant bar.
Yeah, dude. Right, that's what they call the Coliseum. The last
you would just go there. There's things happening.
The last dive bar. Yeah, you just treat the you treat the stadium like your bar. That's the fucking coolest. But I
mean,
don't know.
Wrigley is a fucking bar. Shit.
Yeah.
Period.
How much does a ticket go for at Wrigley though?
Up top, nothing.
Really? Because
yeah, it's still cheap up there.
That's dope. See, that's the way baseball games should be. They should be cheap as fuck, like for the way ups.
I would love to go to a Cubs game. I only went to one. My aunt took me for my second communion, so I'm 8 years old.
That's cool.
And she took me, and I bought a neon pink Cubs hat.
Yep.
And I remember my dad being like a little bummed that I came home with the neon pink.
Wait, did we hear this?
Yeah, we heard this
okay.
2 weeks ago.
2 weeks ago.
Yeah. Nice.
His memory has left him again.
he drank some fucking $10,000 whiskey, and he's like... Yeah.
He started drinking, it's gone.
Sorry, dude. Sorry. Yeah. I didn't mean to blow you up.
The Rip Van Winkle.
It's a real in and out. It's real in and out.
He's back.
I was pap smeared.
Yeah.
I got pap smeared.
Whoa, you were what?
Yeah, that's what happens when you get drunk on Pappy Van Winkle.
You get pap smeared. All right.
That's life. I love it, baby.
The Cubs won a couple years ago. 2016, the Cubs took the series. Isn't that right?
They did. It was, what a moment.
There we go.
But yeah, I'd love to go as an adult. It seems mad fun.
I mean, it is fun, but it's also just... A lot of drunk people kicking it, high-fiving. The high-fiving.
Yeah.
I think that's where it was invented.
See, that's where we differ, Durs, because I could get drunk and high-five all day long. I would love to do that with a bunch of strangers.
Not for me.
I'm also okay with high-fiving. I miss human contact, especially in large groups of people, and it is
really
awesome. Yep.
Really?
Oh, I'm back. I'm back to touching strangers. Yeah.
Yeah. I feel like I now buy... like habit fist bump way more than ever before just because of the pandemic. I was like, all right, we fist bump. And then now that I'm just like fist bumping way too much.
Yeah.
Oh yeah. You're still on it. See, I've ditched it.
You got to get in the hugs.
Yeah.
Kisses. You got to kiss them.
I go right to the bro hug and then bring them in close.
And then just eat their butt right quick.
Yeah.
I just kiss them straight up.
I just open mouth kiss them.
Yeah,
that's kind of cool.
I just eat their asshole.
just go straight to shortstop.
I just quickly
shortstop.
Spin them around.
You shortstop me.
Cool. Hey, pucker up.
Yeah, baby.
Pucker up. This is my first base.
Pucker up.
Pucker up. That's it.
But that's cool. You know, just like eating somebody's butt when you meet them is cool. But like. Fist bumping? I don't know. I definitely feel like an old man who's like fist bumping a youngster.
Yeah.
Well, we are old, and there are lots of people younger than us. I'm just going to say that, and it feels more like that. I feel that more and more every day, especially when I go out into crowds, because there's not a lot of old people in the crowds. Mm-hmm. It's all the youngsters that are going out.
Can you grab that for me, young man?
Yeah, you're going to the wrong parties, dude.
Yeah.
You need to go to cool, like, old guy rules parties.
Yeah.
Well,
you got to hang out with Blake. Blake knows where all the cool old guys are.
Right.
Kyle, you play pickleball.
Blake's the weird guy at the skate park who's like, come here. Look at you. Here, sag your pants a little lower.
Kyle's actively hanging out with old people. He's like going to the pickleball matches.
Yeah. What do you mean? You're surrounded by oldies.
Well, what do you? I was talking about parties. I'm not talking about the pickleball court. I'm talking about like when I saw you play when you were at your thing. You DJ'd at the Comic-Con, man. There was so many young fucking people there.
But also, it was Nasty Neck. It was Nuge. All those guys are older than we are.
I'm just saying.
Don't do that to them.
And who?
Adam, stop. Don't do that to them.
What's wrong with being
that,
old?
That also, no, there's nothing. I'm just saying the people that are out and about are more often younger than us. That's all I'm saying.
Wow.
Yes, usually by this point of people's lives, they're at home with their families. That is correct.
I hope not.
That's all that I'm saying. That's it. That's
Blake
all I'm
hopes
saying.
Not. Blake hopes not.
Dude, we should be in Croatia, baby. Let's go. Come on. That's where the real grown men's is at.
No, they're at hedonism, doggy.
That's for the future Nancy Reagans of the world.
Hey, no, let's let that sit there. Let's just let that, let's let that lie there for a second. What did you just say, Blake? That's where the real grown men's is?
The grown men's is really, really off the coast of Croatia, baby. That's a grown man area.
Okay. Can you elaborate?
I'm saying it's a, probably a very wealthy area. You're not going to see a lot of young money out there. It's probably a lot of old dudes with big boats.
Okay. So it's like Monaco. It's like Monte Carlo. Is it by Monte Carlo?
It's the, over that direction. Yeah.
Kyle, did you want to talk about Monte Carlo?
No, I'm just, when he painted that picture, it sounded like.
Kyle's been to a place once and he wants to tell us about it.
When he painted that picture, it sounded like Monaco. Okay.
I believe it is like kind of cliffside-y like that.
That's what it's looking like to me. Very cliffside, very, very blue. It's on the Adriatic Sea. Is that?
Where the fuck is this place?
I like how you somehow had an issue pronouncing sea.
No, when I got to sea, I was doubting.
Sea was like a question mark.
I was doubting what I had just said, and it leaked into sea because Adriatic doesn't sound like something that should be found in that part of the world.
Okay.
Sounds like
it is. You're in charge of naming things now.
Oh,
it just doesn't flow off the tongue like Croatia.
Dude, it is near that. It's over on the other side of the boot in Italy. See, Monte Carlo's on the other side. So, yeah, I bet it's similar vibes.
I want to talk about locations in regards to where they are as from Monte Carlo. Like, okay, so,
exactly.
You were in Portland, Oregon, and Monte Carlo is over there. Yeah, great. Go ahead. Now I understand the context.
Right. Well, that's essentially our manager, Isaac, anytime we're anywhere with him, and he's like, so, like, Orange County is about 1,400 miles from here.
Right.
So, so we're like halfway across the country.
He does that for locations, and then for timeline stuff, he'll be like, I mean, that was like 4 years before punk rock happened, so.
Let's see, Dead Kennedys dropped in.
That was like 75. It was like, let's see, like that was 2004, because punk rock had been dead officially.
Yeah, well, Sid Vicious died. let's see. The punk rock timeline.
Burn! I will say, just when I was in Monte Carlo, $100.
Okay, go off.
Wasn't that many years ago?
Trop House.
No, this I think you guys would dig this. This is for you guys. I think you'd dig this. During F1, $100.
Oh, yeah, I'm a huge F1 nut.
$100 beers.
Formula One.
Yeah.
$100
bottle
of
beer, right?
No, that's what it was. That was the base level drink.
But I think they do that to be like, I bought $100 beer.
Well, sure.
Well, yeah. I mean, it's like $1 million for 10 feet by 10 feet in Monte Carlo. It's like the most expensive spot on planet Earth.
Yeah.
So,
and you owned it for a week.
I just fucking hung out, bro. I just hung out.
So $100 for like just a regular.
That's like Dubai.
That was during the race. It's not like that because I was there, I don't know, a year after you. And we went and fucking kicked. I think I talked about this on the pod how Em and I went. We were there on July 4th. We were just in France and we went over to Monte Carlo and it was July 4th. And we saw these people setting up for like a fucking July 4th USA celebration, but it hadn't opened yet. It was like lunchtime and we were hungry and we're like, are you guys open? They're like, yeah, we're open right now. And then in whatever French accent. And then all of a sudden.
Do the French accent.
Yeah, do it.
Can you do a French accent?
The waiters and waitresses start coming out and they're all in Indian headdresses and like basketball uniforms because they're like, America, July 4th, basketball and Indians. Cool. And we were like, fuck, this is hilarious.
They were wearing like a Native American like headdresses.
Yes, because they were just like celebrating America. So that's their view from.
I love that. That is absolutely absurd.
Like super hot waitresses in like the headdresses with the feathers. And then all the dudes were dressed in like Kobe jerseys.
Yeah, they just saw like some photos of Coachella and they're like, this is how they dress now. This is like how they.
Right, exactly.
This is America. They just have Kygo cranking on the fucking loudspeakers. Hello. I love that.
Hit us with a little bit, Blake. Hit us with some Kygo.
I also saw, and Kyle, I don't know how much time you had to kill and like scope out the scene, but I saw a Gucci kids store.
Oh yeah,
Gucci.
Yeah, I was, no, like, I was all around.
This
that.
Is hilarious.
Yes, yes, they have the craziest, most expensive shit in Monte Carlo. It's just, it's absurd. That's truly absurd.
And you kind of are like, when you're there, if you're rich, I imagine
you're like, do I get $100 beer?
You buy it because you're like, this is hilarious. I'm so rich. They price $100. Yes, two.
I'm right.
You guys have never been to Dubai, right? I heard like it, that's kind of like it out there.
No, we got to do the podcast at the W at Dubai.
That would be ill.
Oh, have you guys heard of this? What, it's expensive? Where are they building it? In, I think it's Saudi Arabia. They're building that new city.
Saudi.
Called Neom.
Neom.
Okay.
It's, okay, I mean, I'm listening. Look it up. It's absolutely.
It's the hot new city.
Is it on water?
They're building. It's in the middle of the desert, and they're building like their own ocean,
like a Vegas
and lake. Right. But it's going to be huge, like an actual city. I think it's supposed to fit 9 million people, and it's going to be in a bubble. It's going to be in a dome.
What the hell? We can do that?
So this is the problem, because they did this in China, and now there's like ghost cities where like nobody lives there. But it's
hello,
people
vice.
It's it's like people who are building these buildings, making money, acting as if people are gonna be moving there, and then no one moves there, and there's entire cities that are just like empty. But good luck.
This place looks like it's out in the middle. It looks like it's by the water, this Neom place.
How do you spell it?
Neom. N-E-O-M. Neom.
Are we moving there? I mean, L.A. is getting out of hand.
It's like a full smart city where all the new technologies and everything. And there's like they're building the skyscrapers instead of straight up. They're building them in a line. So the skyscrapers are going to be stacked on top of each other, and it goes miles and miles and miles long.
Durs, are you saying that these are just like hot new tickets that people invest in and they get rich off it, but they are absolutely not sustainable and nobody wants to live there after they become not a fad? Is that kind of...
Yeah, they're building it promising like that people will move in, and they're getting paid by like the government and other people, and then... people don't move because there's no job opportunities out there or whatever.
Right.
You know?
Yeah, so Neom is a futuristic megacity 33 times the size of New York City.
A megalopolis?
Jesus.
And it is being built on the Red Sea in northwest Saudi Arabia.
There's that many people that are that wealthy that they can afford to live there?
Exactly, no.
Yeah, what the hell?
Look at this website's off the chain.
And yeah, and it's costing them $500 billion to make.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that seems like
a steal.
That seems like a steal.
Well, yeah, to like build a whole functioning like infrastructure. Yeah, that seems about right.
Oil money, baby.
We forgot the toilets.
oops. It's just one giant W hotel. You can never find a goddamn light switch.
Can we rewind? You said that they're building skyscrapers that just lay on top of each other. I don't understand that.
Yeah, look, I mean, look it up. I really don't know.
Look it up, bitch.
It's called the line, is what they're calling it.
Horizontal skyscrapers.
Right. Isn't that just a hotel in LA?
The Line Hotel. Love it.
Shout out.
Yeah, this place looks weird as hell, man, but I would go there. I don't know. But I heard, like, in Dubai, you're not allowed to drink. It's illegal. It's like prohibition out there.
Oh, they're in prohibition. They're in their 20s.
Yeah, but they still do it, don't they?
You can only drink in hotels or something. It sounds kind of...
So the parties, okay. So parties are going to be on our charts. Yeah.
I guess it's a no-go for us then, huh?
Yeah, no, I'm trying to, you know, go out to a little bar or, you know, go outside.
What the fuck?
You don't want to just blaze a hookah?
Well, let's just go to different hotels and you drink at their bar.
Man, I don't think it's that easy. I think it has to be in your room.
Here we go.
I think you're just
this is misinformation.
We're getting some facts down here. You can drink if you're rich and a famous person. They have exceptions, is what one of our producers said. I'm not going to say who.
I don't know. That sounds.
Hey, sign me up.
So what? You have to be on Raya?
They check your star meter, and if it's low enough, you can drink.
Yeah, exactly. What's the quantifier?
Oh my god.
Fuck, dude. That's fucked up.
Fuck,
bro.
Dude.
I would love to go vacation somewhere fucking weird with you guys. Let's.
Yeah. This sounds like it might be the one.
What, Dubai?
You think?
Yeah.
Or Neom? Zeom?
Neom. No. We got to go to Neom, bro.
Neom. Yeah. Sorry.
I'm trying to live in Neom.
I don't think Neom is. It's not done yet. I think they just broke ground on it.
It's not?
But let's go now and like point around and be like, yeah, over here. Yeah, that'll be sick.
Yeah, exactly. We're the first ones here.
Yeah. What up?
I know it's just a desert right now, but.
I'm looking at these horizontal skyscrapers, bro.
We heard you could drink here.
I'm looking at these horizontal skyscrapers, man.
It's the future of urban living.
What do you mean horizontal? Because that means flat.
That's what I'm trying to find, yeah, the flat ones that Adam was talking
that's
about.
That's a ground scraper, bro.
Yeah.
It's just like one tunnel.
Do you see it? Do you see the line?
Yes,
it's
points!
Like, yeah.
It's just like one like horizontal piece that connects like two buildings together or something like that. It's like a walkway.
But it goes like 50 miles or something.
Oh, sure. But they have that in Minneapolis.
I know. This is, I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not sold on Neom, dude.
Oh, wait. This one's fucking sick.
Hey, man, I'm not selling it. I don't work for the Saudi prince. I'm just saying that.
Are you sure?
You guys, I'm already there.
It reveal.
Please, don't shit on it. I'm already here.
No, it actually does look tight.
I just moved.
I moved
here.
My whole family here.
I just moved. The schools are supposed to be really good. They got no toilets.
I'm watching like the video of what Neom and the line is going to be, and it's absolutely—it's like the future of urban living. And then it just shows this girl
that you're just watching the trailer for the new Avatar.
I mean, honestly, it looks like it. It shows a girl like flying, like
Peter Pan style,
using superpowers and flying through the city. I'm like, I don't know if that's possible.
As soon as you enter the city, you get your mutant power.
Neom, humans can fly.
I like it.
Did you say it's in a bubble? It's actually in a dome?
I believe so, yeah.
You guys don't get it. You'll get it when you get here.
Yeah, so no COVID. No COVID in the bubble.
Keeps the COVID out in Neom.
In Neom. You can fuse your DNA with your favorite animal.
Yeah, I would love to do one of those like crazy Instagram vacations out to someplace absurd. You know, where you're like working out on top of a skyscraper.
Yeah, that'd be kind of cool.
Like that's where you do yoga. You're like,
we're just beer bonging.
Yeah.
Yeah, we're not influencers enough. We got to be more of an influencer. Yeah. I feel like our fans aren't really that influenced by what we do.
Yeah, I mean, let's just keep it real. We're just going to be sitting there and fucking laughing. Nothing is going to come of it.
We don't post much. None of us.
No.
Like, because we don't, do you guys feel the urge?
I go through spurts. Every once in a while, I'll go through a spurt where I feel like posting. And then I'll just not do it for like 3 months and be like, oh, yeah, okay.
Instagram's always been like work to me, though. Like, I post like mostly work shit. Like, I'm like, okay, I'm in Comic-Con. I'm releasing a movie. I'm doing this TV show. Right. Like, and then I have a burst. And then other than that.
Our work lines and our like friendship lines are super blurred, though. So, like, I feel like it is my life. But I don't like post about my family and stuff that much on the Instagram, you know?
Never.
Right.
I think they want that, though, right? They want the engagement. They want to see your vacation. They want to, like, see you beating off.
Well, I mean, the last time I was doing that stuff was when I was on...
I think so. As soon as I have a kid, I'm going to exploit them.
They want to see your dick.
When I was on Vine, that's what I was using Vine for back in the day, was a lot of vacation footage and stuff. You know?
So, right. This six-second video is mostly just vacation footage.
That's I'm like, on the beach. Peace.
Yeah.
That was guys, I'm out. Time runs
I'm
out.
I'm here in beautiful...
Hey, hey guys, I just landed in...
I just landed in. By the way, timing your Vine, that was an art form. Hey, lost King, art.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
King Batch, you are not my friend. I am sorry, all right?
So
wait,
good.
You're saying I'm not King Batch. I thought you said King Batch, you're not my friend. I'm like, why are you doing that?
Yeah, no. Why are you shitting on King Batch?
Very good friends.
Yeah, he's a bud.
Yeah.
Had a very funny post the other day. I sent it to Blake.
A good guy.
Which one?
Where he was like, you got to go on this feed, bro. I'm not getting tangled.
No, I know. I definitely am. I watch him. So I just want to know if I laughed.
I might have you guess, and I'm not telling, but
I'm not telling, man.
We'll
you
do
tell
it after.
Me what,
I'm not
but
telling.
This is
I'm
good
telling.
Podcasting. I'll tell you.
Are there any takebacks, apologies, giveaways, epic slams?
I would like to apologize for any misinformation about Nancy Reagan that we may have put into the universe. That's our bad. You know,
we just report
knows?
On what we see.
That's all. We're just reporting.
It is cool that
gack.
Like somehow someone got the inside scoop on Nancy Reagan 70 years later. Mm-hmm. They're like, well, we have to make this viral.
That it finally leaked.
We leaked it.
And Bill Russell just died. I just saw a news thing. Bill Russell, the world famous Celtic basketball center, mm-hmm. one of the best basketball players to ever live. Yeah. I actually have a funny photo. R.I.P. Bill Russell. But I have a funny photo
of Wayne Gretzky.
We're pissing next to each other at a urinal.
Oh, wow.
Me and Bill Russell. And it looks like he's looking down at my dick. So
that's cool.
It definitely looks like he is, which is...
Rest in peace.
And that's cool, man. Way to honor him.
Which is very funny, and I would like to honor him.
Way to honor him.
Yeah. And that's going to be my RIP photo of him. I'm finally going to get back on Instagram and post that photo to honor him.
By the way, truly, awesome. When people are talking about Jordan or LeBron, who's the greatest, I'm like, how are we all not just going... So there's Bill Russell, we know.
Yes.
Who is the greatest? Because he has 8 or 10 rings or something.
10, I think, yeah.
And he was coaching while playing. Yeah.
And he was battling racism as well. It was crazy.
This dude was in a whole other stratosphere. And it's crazy to me that nobody goes, okay, Bill Russell. Now, obviously, like athletically, things progress, right? But everyone's a product of their era. And in his era, this dude had 10 rings.
Yeah.
Some of them while coaching.
Crushing it.
Was he really playing? He was
ultimate stud. So flowers to Bill Russell.
He was a player coach.
Yeah. He was the real deal.
How do you do that?
It's like when you direct an act, we're in awe of you, Kyle.
Kyle, you're our Bill Russell.
Right. Now I get it.
I didn't know he was a player. I thought Red.
Trill Russell.
I thought Red Auerbach was the coach of the Celtics during that run.
He did, but later in Bill Russell's career, he also coached while playing.
That's crazy.
That's so
and correct me if Bill I'm Russell. Wrong. Maybe we'll put an asterisk on this one, but I'm almost positive.
Oh, I like that.
But that's crazy.
Doesn't sound right when you say it like that, asterisk. But
I know. It's an asterisk.
Okay. Yeah, I don't like it.
He looks like when he would show up and give the MVP award. Or no, he would give the championship award.
Yeah, I think it's the Bill Russell trophy.
Yes. I mean, he looked like just a fucking cool-ass wizard.
Yeah.
When his, hair got hella white. And he's, 7 feet tall. Like,
he's
you don't
huge,
live that
man.
Long and be 7 feet tall. That's wild.
Yeah, he's cool.
And he had, the best laugh. That dude, you would see, players crack him up, and he would just be like a full-body laugh. I love this dude.
I made him laugh once, and Candace Parker.
Because you your dick at the urinal?
Yeah, he saw my dick.
Oh, my God.
I actually seen that one in Game Over, man, dude.
Yeah, Candace Parker was like, yeah, he doesn't give up laughs that easily.
What?
Like, yeah, that's what she said. She said he was like a hard
I bet
hard
you could
going.
Find a YouTube video of Bill Russell laughing. He's constantly on the stage just full body laughs.
Well,
or NBA
maybe
players.
She was just hyping me up.
But hell Adam funny. I think well, yeah, she was
He also played at the University of San Francisco. Shout out Bay Area legend Bill Russell.
So tight.
R.I.P. Big Bill.
Yep. Mm.
So those are my flowers. I gave flowers.
Good. Mm.
Okay,
I
tight.
Love it.
Tight.
Can I get one of those flowers to give? Can I get one of those?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
Cool, thanks. Flowers. What are you drinking?
Kyle? This is water.
Kyle, there something you want to get off your chest before we hang up?
I was just trying to remember what they are. Dead ringers? What is it? Oh, I have something. I had ringer? Something. I have a candy complaint. No, a candy criticism.
All right. I'm going to go.
No, I'm here for it. I love candy criticism. What we got?
I totally forgot. I totally have a brand new candy criticism.
Is this a new segment?
Yeah. Yeah.
Kyle's Corner.
Candy criticisms.
Now, this is just if anybody who can make this change, if they're listening. But I'm a huge fan of Reese's, the cups. Okay?
Mm-hmm. I like the cups. To be clear, the cups.
I like the cups. Now, the problem is I haven't had one of those candies in a very long time that came off of the wrapper clean. There's always a little piece of the cup that's stuck on the fucking little cup thing.
Right. And you party with old people.
You know what's to blame about that? It's global warming. It's too hot.
Yeah, dude.
It's too hot.
Yeah. If you keep them in your fridge, keep them in your fridge.
But I would think that they can fix this. They should be able to fix this. They used to have
keep them in your refrigerator.
Well, okay. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you so much. But sometimes if I'm just going to buy it from the store and eat it in the car, this is when they're sitting on the rack, by the way. This is when they're at Home Depot. So I just go into my car.
This guy's lunch. This dude's Home Depot lunch. I love
it. It's frustrating, guys.
I can't stop eating.
And the small ones, are even worse than the big ones.
Why is it so frustrating? Just lick the
just
thing.
Lick it. Yeah,
like
lick it.
Yeah, it's part of the fun. It's like licking a yogurt top.
Yeah, what the fuck, bro? Why is it all got to be in one piece?
Fuck out of here.
Fucking bafangoo.
I'm just going to let that land.
Kyle. Did you guys ever take the cup wrapper, like the black cup wrapper?
Uh-huh.
And then you like apply it to your teeth and from far away it looks like you got no teeth?
Oh, no. We did that with gum wrappers to look like
gum make it grills. Look like a grill. Yeah, there was a lot of that.
Gum, it makes like it look like a grill.
With the like winter fresh silver.
Oh, got it. Yeah. Yes.
You know what, Durs? I bet when people did that, though, they were trying to bite the rest of the fucking cup off the bottom, and they were like, look, you got no teeth.
Happy accident.
No, I guess I'll say it's a candy compliment now. It's a compliment.
It's a candy compliment.
Oh, it went from a candy criticism.
That was another episode of
Kyle's Corners Candy Criticism.
This is important.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, thanks, Blake. Yeah, play us out, baby.
You got it, brother. Todd, just cut this off at 50. Think about it. Oh, my God. This is good.
Oh, yeah.
This is Trop House, baby.
Trop House.
All right.